his team on the board to start the game for the Rams. Street throw is good.
There's a few things that make Wall important to his team. I think the number one factor is his leadership. His guys look to him to set the tone on both ends. He doesn't disappoint.
That one is no good.
He's upset he missed on a chance to give them the lead, but he misses.
Here's Murphy with a block, and he's able to get it back. They recover it. Lijuan's shot is good.
Love the grid on the offensive glass. Those two step off.
And he'll kick for the ball. Lee Benes was put in just the right spot.
Whoa, his skill is scoring down low. He's using his size and speed to create for himself.
Harden the pass to Murphy. He set the pick. Houston moving the ball around. Ball's not loose. Porter with the steal. And here we go. Washington fast break. And that one, good. Olajuwon, 13 feet away, and the jumper falls for it. Olajuwon's got six.
Nice way to start the game. And his numbers getting called. Well, yeah, he's a guy who can carry you for stretches, long stretches in this game. You want to get him the ball early and hard.
And a sweet top five ball.
The ball is a blur. His speed is just incredible. Gets to the cup.
Points for him.
Offensively, it's been a perfect quarter. And he hasn't missed a single shot.
Another shot by Wall.
Well, there's nothing the smaller defender can do but just look up and watch himself get schooled.
Now here's Drexler. Ball's got loose. Harden outside. Brings it from beyond the arc. Harden's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three.
There's a chance he could go for a big one. They would beat him up on the bridge.
Beal against Harden. Beal versus the Morris. Just five to shoot. Here's Gortat. And Gortat with a stop.
Now that's just the long arms of Gortat easily stretching out to Gobbler.
And we're just over 3.5 minutes into the first quarter. Beal against Harden. Oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. It's going to go on Markieff Morris. Houston shooting their first free throws of the night. Free throw good. James Harden. Ty Lawson, he's checked in for Washington. Harden hits them both.
And what an advantage. You really feel like you can always trust him when he's at the
Lawson's against Murphy. The shot's good from Lawson.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Harden the post to Olajuwon. It's stolen by Morris. And here's the fast break. Beal leading the way. Now again, Washington with the triple.
Well, that's just the fast hands. You can't be careless around that. It's tricky with arm.
There's the dish to Olajuwon. They set the pick. Here's Harden.
Oh, that's an old-fashioned rim rack.
Just a remarkable jam. These fans' jaws are on the ground right now. And unleashed chaos. Another replay really giving us a good look at this. And so he draws the foul on the shot.
too much space from there, man. It doesn't hurt him there. They keep doing that.
I'll tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
The Wizards have been successful on 3 of their 4 free throw attempts up to this point. To John Wall. And so John Wall nails both of them. We've got 1:23 left in the first quarter. And Murphy gets to Elijah Wan. Pass to Murphy. Softly drops in the floor.
Good movement there. Lead pass was right where it was.
All against Murphy. Wall, that's good. Wall's got 13.
Now about 5 of 6 to start. Looks like he brought his A game.
Rockets trail by 6. McGrady kicks to Elijah Wan. That's good. Great play set by T-Mac, Tracy McGrady.
And they repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
He's going outside, and the Wizards hit again from T-Mac.
Already in a flow, some stellar shooting.
Hit by now, McGrady, and another 3 for Houston.
Okay, we got a nice little back and forth going here.
And I love it, Greg. Both sides are taking advantage.
We'll see how the defense goes.
And Wojcik kicks to Beal. And a wide open shot for Morris. And again, Washington with the triple.
When you open, Beal find it. I'm saying it.
Rockets ball as Houston keeps possession. What? 15 seconds left in the opening quarter. Murphy gets Wall. And Murphy gets the McGrady. Oh, we can hit. Wojcik. Unable to hit that one. John Wall getting it done for the Washington Wizards. He put together quite a quarter. 13 points in all. And he looks to be planning for more. We've got more in store for you right after this. And the first quarter is in the books. Second about to get underway. And what stands out to you from Washington? And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. Here's the Sydney Bird of play. So on the floor, Francis. They've got now Drexler out there with Tracy McGrady, and it's Francis with the points. Mahamian's shot is good.
But as he played to get his hand in there and get the steal, intelligent play to immediately stop the ball.
Gets it to Simpson. Shot clock at 6. Drexler outside. Rebounded by the Wizards. They want to keep rolling here, following the win against the Thunder.
And always tough on the road, but the attack mindset that they brought offensively, I really felt like that set them apart.
Well, also great execution. Let's not forget about that. They even had control so far.
Here's the foul. It's on the heat. That is his first foul of the game. Here's Beal. Mahimi's shot is good. Mahimi's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific.
And Houston calls their first timeout of the game. And we're now about 1.5 minutes into the second quarter. McGrady outside. There's the 3. It's John Wall with the rebound.
And you know what? You can't get a better screen. Frees him up beautifully, but he just fails to capitalize.
The best laid plans, right? Well, I'll tell you right there, though, that's what they'll take every single time.
There's Beal with the 3. And that comes off the assist by John Wall. His first 2 points of the night.
I'm sure he loves that matchup. He gives him a big size advantage.
Outside Wall over Francis. Rodman dishes to Wall. Shooting their 7th and 8th attempts at the foul line tonight.
And at the line last season, about 78% as a team. Pretty solid numbers.
That free throw missing. Washington making some changes. Porter's checked in for Scott. And it's Jody Meeks in for Bradley Beal. It's the second from the line. Rockets trail by 13. McGrady outside. Second foul of the game.
Oh, he's not happy to pick up a second foul. This early in the game, he's got to be careful about it.
Drexler outside. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Drexler's got his second basket of the night.
That's all he needs, just an inch of separation from beyond the arc.
And the three ball is good.
Anything you can do, I can do better. We have a gamesmanship going on. I like this. It feels like it's getting a little personal out there. It could make it
Houston shooting their third free throw shot of the game. And in the second quarter, a little under 3.5 minutes played already. Meeks outside. And so it looks like Washington retained possession here. Back to Porter. And the three ball is good. Porter's got 6 points.
First came into the league, he didn't have this shot. Now he's a knockdown for another shot.
Here's Yao, no good. And Washington the other way now. Porter passes to Mahimi, the kick out to Porter. Nice ball movement by Washington. Here's Wall, and he makes good on the lift. 16 points for him.
Wall could be one of the most dangerous scorers in the game, especially when he gets hot. Keep getting in the run.
Hit by Yao. Knocked away. Ball against Smith. And off the front.
Time out.
18 points for John Moore.
Right. Well, he's playing a smart, strong game. His field goal percentage is improving.
Timeout call for Rockets. Look at John Moore. What a contribution so far. Here's what Washington's going with right now. Oubre is checked in for Rockets. And Bradley Beal subjected for Dwayne Mahimi. Shots good by Drexler.
Nice work to get in position for the rebound and the putback. He has no off switch.
Wizards leading by 15. Over the corner, Meeks. And it's Beal in the corner. 56 left in the second quarter. That one, no good. Fires the three. Harden's shot is off. Let's it go with a three. And there's Bradley Beal on the assist by Meeks. Meeks got the assist tonight. Harden kicks the out. Back to Harden. To the paint. And the ball trap.
to Harden. Clyde Drexler on the way. Six to shoot. Good. It's Harden with the assist that time. Drexler's got seven now in this quarter.
Oh, he's doing his best to get them back into this game. He's been money for them, too.
There's 14 seconds left in the first half of the game. And ball kicks to Beal. And the Wizards hit again from deep.
Beal is on a roll. Keep getting him the rock. He's an outstanding scorer.
And so it's Washington, sitting on a 21-point lead to end the quarter. And with as many three-pointers as they drink, it's easy to see why they're on the cusp of a blowout.
Hey again, everybody. So far, pretty lopsided game, but still one half to play. I'm Ernie Johnson, joined by Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jake Smith. It was a great half of basketball from John Wall. He had 18 points, 2 assists, and 1 steal. His great performance last game out seemed to carry right over into tonight. And let's get your thoughts, Kenny, on the Wizards.
They've done a lot of things well, but the way they've taken care of the basketball, valuing each possession so critical to the tempo, so crucial to the offensive flow. They got a great rhythm, as smart and as safe as they're playing. They made it clear they're not going to beat themselves today.
And Shaq, let's get your input on the Rockets.
Well, the bottom line is they got to defend the 3-point line much better. They were concentrating all their effort into protecting the paint, and these guys were standing.
As Rebecca returned to Washington, D.C. As we begin the second half, first down wasn't even close, guys. Wizards leading by 21. Flores and Gerton together down low. A great scoring pair of wings. Quarter to 3. And it's Wall in at the point guard. That's the room for Scott Brooks getting going here in the second half.
Way to attack the rim with that ferocity. I love the intensity that Wall plays with. When he's penetrating, he's looking dunking every time.
Bajon takes the Drexler. Hooked away. Porter with the steal. And here we go with Morris. Running it up. And Wall with the slam.
Look at Morris break down the defense on this play. If they leave one of these guys open, he's going to get it to him fast.
Here's Harden. Let's it go from the baseline and nails it. Harden's got 9 points.
Nice bucket. There's no question about his skill for the offense.
Out to Morris. Morris puts it down.
That's just great awareness from the savvy point guard. Morris, excellent at sharing the weapon.
This is to Elijah Wan. Points for him.
And he can smell blood in the water. Excellent finish.
Well, you're up by double digits. They're trying to keep the momentum. Keep the foot on the lid. That's his focus right now.
Now a timeout called by Houston.
Yeah, the amount of points they've given up here in the main, and that's what we've got to talk about.
Ooh, this is no question about it. And you wonder if these matchups aren't favoring them right now.
All against Murphy. As it goes out of bounds, Houston able to keep the ball. Pick by Olajuwon. Murphy passes to Harden. Moves and pick just right. Harden's got 4 points in the quarter.
And you can see there, the defender gets caught up on the pick.
Team ball. Great execution on offense. Everyone working together. I wish you could have that.
But the defense not putting up any fight on the inside. They've allowed 10 straight points in the game.
That leaves it. And it's out of bounds. It was last touched by Gortat. 5 minutes checked in for Porter. Houston also making some changes. Samson's checked in. Jason McGrady is up in for Murphy. Wall, no luck. And here comes McGrady, leading the fast break. Sampson kicks to Harper. That's in. That's his fifth field goal. He's shooting a hot 71%. 5-7. Right side, Beal. Checked in for Washington, and a switch here also for Houston. Now checked in for Elijah Moore. Here's Beal for the basket. It's number 6 for him this game. 6-9, 67% shooting.
At times, there's no defense. Even if you get his jersey, he keeps his shot high, so you can't get to it.
Now a timeout called by Houston. There's a good screen. He passes to Sampson. Harden outside. And he makes it look easy, tucking it hard with one hand.
And a long windup and strong follow through on the one hand jam.
He's not going to mess that one up. Here's Wall. Get some room on the way. Yeah, and the bucket's good. Wall's got 28.
Love seeing Wall keep going for the mid-range. He has a solid jump shot for this spot.
Sampson shot, good.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Murphy against Wall. That one good for two. Wall's got 12 points in just the second half.
He continues to be their go-to guy. If they close this game out, he's going to be all watching.
From T. Harden. Rebound, Washington. Wall's got his third rebound tonight.
I like that intensity. Wall won't be denied on these type of drives to win.
46 seconds left to play in the third. And Murphy gets to Sampson. Hit by Yao. Here's Sampson. 9 points in the game so far. Gortat with the rebound. Gortat's got his sixth rebound on the night. Here's Wall. Rebound by Yao. Murphy against Wall. Now, here's Murphy. Not a lot of room. With 4 seconds on the clock. Wall, no luck.
Oh, great effort, Jazz. Yeah, he has that capacity. He knows exactly where to position himself.
So it's the Washington Wizards in complete command. They lead at 28 points going into the break. They, but you never know. So on the floor for Houston. Now he's out there at Thorpe. Then there's Maxwell. And it's Smith. And it's Francis in at the two. Coming.
And they've had assists now on their last 3 baskets.
Here's the feed to Meeks. To the right side. And plenty of contact on the shot. So, 2 free throws coming up. And Houston gets called for the foul. And you look at today's players, they have so many more ways to connect with their fans. But there's a time to think that that creates added pressure for the players.
Every player has pressure. I don't know about added pressure. But I do think it's a different time with social media, and you can hear everyone's opinion. So I think that you need to focus more if you're an athlete, but I don't think it adds more pressure. Whether or not someone can type it or say it in your face or boo you in a game, there by Wall. Such an effortless shooting motion on the jump shot.
Pass to Maxwell. And it's off from 3-point range. They're making this a runaway.
And the only question for me right now is just how big the lead will actually be.
Reaching Wall with the slam.
Look at the edge Wall plays with. I love it. When he gets hit, he still remains calm and steady and focuses and knocks the shot down.
The pass to Francis. Ford with a screen on Beal. Beal with the steal. On the wing, Morris. To the middle, shot left block. And the rebound goes for the Rockets. Yao's got 3 rebounds now in this one. That's going to be over in bags. Not watching for the line that time.
They got you careless, Kevin. No doubt about it with their turnovers in the second half.
Olajuwon's checked in for Yao. Outside, Beal scores the bucket. He's 7 for 11 and continues to look good.
Oh, I like watching Beal on the top side. He has a great understanding of how to score close to the bucket.
Oubre picks the court out, stripped away. And here we go. Here's Maxwell. There's one on the floor. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line.
Taking the hit and still able to get that one to go down.
And the game and the culture of basketball has so many subsets. One of those is the basketball shoe culture, the sneaker culture. Players competing almost as much, Chris, for style points as they are for actual points.
And I have to say that I was part of that culture. You know, black socks and different shoes that I've had in the NBA. It's a lot of fun, man. This is something that your fans can relate to. It's something personal. It shows a personal side of what you have, your type of design. So, you know, you're very fortunate if you get your own kick deal, and I was fortunate. It's a lot of fun, and the fans love it.
Otto Porter Jr. is checked in for courtside. Chris, you see some of the rookies coming into the league. They need to put on more weight. They need to build up a little bit. Now, Chris is saying that. Were you looking to add strength when you came into the NBA?
Well, I was fortunate that I already had an NBA-type body, so I really just need to try to bulk up for the NBA. You know, I really disagree that a lot of guys got to get stronger. Look at Kevin Durant. You know, we all know the famous story about how trainers laughed at him when he got to the league. The NBA is unique in that. Do you have skill? Can you play? So, no, Curry doesn't need to put on 25 pounds of muscle. Durant doesn't need to put on 15 pounds of muscle. It's more about your game. It's more about your core, your balance. You pick up natural weight and natural strength as you go along. How is your workout? You know, are you in the gym? Are you lifting? Are you working out? Are you getting stronger? That's great. But you don't have to necessarily try to become bigger and stronger. Just try to make sure you have game. That's most important.
It's Meeks outside. And the rebound goes to the Rockets. Here's Francis. No good on the three. Oubre with it. Nice ball movement by Washington. Rodman. No good with the triple.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Knocks it loose. Meeks with the steal. Rodman kicks the wall. And again, Washington, no good. Olajuwon, the best of Francis. Rebound by Mahimi.
And that's the shot you want to create. They just can't get it to fall.
That just shows you can do everything right sometimes, but still get the wrong result. Does well to burrow his way into the post, but loses his touch on the fifth.
Olajuwon, this is the skip. And he makes good on his first shot of the game. Now, Wall. Mahimi kicks to Rodman, shoots, gets to the corner and buries it.
Look, I don't know how he got that one. You're about as tough of a shot as you can think of.
Last outing for Houston, it was a loss to the Los Angeles Lakers. Here's Ford. Chris, bet celebrations can be seen as showing up the other team. Is there a balance in your mind of how players can celebrate without maybe rubbing it in the other team's face?
I mean, this isn't baseball. You know, if it was the basketball, it was baseball. If we hit a home run, then we could try to. You have respect for your players by how hard you play against them, by preparing for them, by not playing dirty. But basketball, no. The culture is in the parks. The culture is with guys that play and the bench and have. season long and they never get in. What's wrong with being hyped for your teammates? No, I don't think it should be true. I love it. Actually, I think some of these bitches need to turn it up even more. Hopefully, we get a better show on the bench.
Defensively, this is what you.